हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक टू VPM पीपल टेक्निक यूट्यूब चैनल अगेन। हाय, श्वेता पटेल हियर। टुडे माय टॉपिक इज एरे ऑफ प्रिमिटिव डेटा टाइप। दिस इज द पार्ट ऑफ यूनिट 2 एंड द यूनिट नेम इज बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक ऑफ द लैंग्वेज। इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल वी विल लर्न हाउ टू वर्क विथ एरे इन अ जावा, दैट मीन्स व्हाट इज द एरे, देन द टाइप्स ऑफ एरे, and we will learn how to declare, initialize and access array element with the help of simple example. First, we discuss what is the array. An array is a collection of similar type of data. It is a container that holds data of one single type. For example, like this, we can create an array that hold 100 value of integer type. Java array is an object which contain an element of similar data type. Additionally, the element of an array are stored in a contiguous memory location. We have already used array in C and C++. So we are familiar with the array and we have perform a lot of programs in C and C++. Array is a special type of data structure where we store a similar elements. We can store only a fixed set of elements in a Java array. Array are used to store a multiple values in a single variable instead of declaring a separate variable for each value. We can access an array element by referring to the index number. Array in a Java work differently than they do in a C and C++. So there are some important points about a Java array, like Java array are dynamically allocated. Java array are object, so we can find the length of the elements using the member length. This is the different from C and C++, where we find the length using a size of. A Java array can also be declared like a other variable with the square bracket after the data types. The variable in array are order and each have an index beginning from 0. Java array can be also be used as a static field, local variable or method parameter, etc. The size of an array must be specified by an integer value and not long or short. So these are some special factors for Java array, which are different from C and C++. Now we discuss the structure of array. This is the structure of one-dimensional array. Here, age 0, age 1, age 2, age 3, and age 4 are the index of the array element. 12, 4, 5, 2, and 5 are the value of array element. Suppose you want to access the array element, then we have to use this index for accessing the array element. Based on the types of array, we can define the structure of array. Like the types of array. The first one is single dimensional array. That means a single dimensional array of Java is a normal array where the array contains sequential elements. That means it generates only a one index number and it may be start from the, sorry, it compulsory start from the 0 and it is end with the array size -1. The second type is multidimensional array. Multidimensional array, it is a nothing but an array of array and it contains two types, two-dimensional array and three-dimensional array. The example of two-dimensional array is a matrix. 3x3 matrix is an example of two-dimensional array. And so we can say that a two-dimensional array is an array of a one-dimensional array. And a three-dimensional array is an array of a two-dimensional array. So these are the types of array. Now we discuss the features of array in a Java. The first one is array are object type. That means in a C, array are a derived type. In a C and C++, array are a derived type. But in a Java, array are a primitive and a non-primitive data type. That means we can declare array with the primitive data type as well as a non-primitive data type, like a reference data type. So in a Java, array are a objects. Array can even hold the reference variable of other object in a Java. That means array also contain the reference variable, object variable of other object. They are created during a runtime. That means we can create an array at a runtime. They are dynamic, created on the heap. In a Java, array are a dynamic and it is created on the heap. The array length is fixed in a Java. So these are the features of array in a Java. Now we discuss how to declare an array. The first syntax for declaring the array is type, variable name and square bracket. There are a different ways in which we can declare array in a Java. This is the simple manner in which we can declare the array. For declaring an array, we require the type, that is the primitive data type, like an integer, float, double, etc. Then variable name or array name and the square bracket. The square bracket is used to indicate the size of array. That means the array which can hold the number of elements. The another way in which we use the array with the square bracket, but the square bracket are defined, predefined before the variable name. So this is the another way in which we can declare the array. We can also declare an array using a new keyword. Java new keyword is used to create an instance of a class. In other words, it initialize or it instantiate a class by allocating a memory for a new object and it returning a reference to that memory. Here, array are also an object in a Java. So we can also use the new keyword to create the array object. So here we can create an array with using a new keyword. So these are the way in which we can declare the array. This is the example for declaring the array. So this is declaring an array in a Java. Now we discuss how to initialize array in a Java. Same as in C and C++, we can declare array in a two way, at a compile time or at a runtime. That means during the compilation time or declaration time or after declaration time. We discuss the first one, initialize an array during a declaration time. Like type array name, square bracket equal to new type, then square bracket, then value of array. That means we specify the value of array at declaring a array. Whenever we declare the array, at the same time we also declare the value of array, like this. This is the example in which we initialize the array during the declaration time. That means we declare the array with its value. And this is the another way we can declare or we can initialize array at a declaration time. So this is the example of initializing array in a Java during a declaration time. The another way for initializing array at a runtime, that means after declaration of array. And for that we have a two way, either we can enter the elements of array from command line argument, or we can enter the array element using the scanner class. I will show you here the simple example in which I enter the array elements using the command line argument. That means I use here args argument string array for passing the elements of array. So this is the example to initialize array at a runtime. After declaring an array, we can assign the value to an array.
Let's see the example, the practical example for how to declare array, how to initialize array, and how to access the elements of array. For that, I have already created one practical. In this practical, first of all, I created one class. The class name is ArrayDemo, in which class contain the main method, public static void main, string args. The string arguments, it is an example of array, one-dimensional type of array. Now, first I declare an array for using a primitive data type, that is the integer. Then A is the array name, then square bracket equal to new integer, then the array size is a 5. So this is the array declaration. I use here a variable I for declaring and initializing and then after displaying the array elements. Now, this is the example of array. After declaration of array, we have to enter the elements of array from the keyboard. So I use here command line argument for entering the elements of array. For that, I create a one for loop. The for loop is start from the 0 and it is end from the size minus 1. Then a of I equal to integer dot parse int args of I. The data type of args of I is a string. So we have to convert this string into a integer using the integer wrapper class dot parse int method. Using this statement, we can convert the string data type into a integer type. So this statement is used to enter the array element using the command line argument. After entering this elements, we can display the elements using the statement, the elements of array are, and then after this statement, we can display the array elements. Now we see the output of this program. For that, we write here Java C. Java C compiler is used to compile the program. My program name is arraydemo.java. Then enter. There is no error in the program. Now we display the output of this program. For that, we write here Java, that is the interpreter, then file name, that is the array demo. And this is the command line argument program. So we have to specify here the argument like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and then enter. The element of array are 5, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, but there is one problem in this program. Suppose I specify only 3 elements for the elements of array, then this will generate the error. And the error is java.language.arrayIndexOutOfBound. That means the size of array are not matched with the index of array. For that, we provide the one solution. And the solution is that we write here the size of array is the same as the length of the argument, that is the args.length. The length is used to find out the total length of argument, and it is also used to find out the total elements of array. So in this program, we make the size of array is the same as the size of argument length. So we put this statement in a everywhere where we use the size of array. જ્યાં આપણે size of array નો use કરીએ છીએ ત્યાં બધી જગ્યાએ આપણે args.length લખીશું. Why? Because the size of array is automatically become the argument length. Means આપણે argument length માં જેટલી ભી length specify કરીશું, it will be automatically make that it is the size of array. Now save this program and again run this program. For that, again we have to compile this program, and then after we specify the argument. See here, suppose I specify here only 3 arguments, then it will be run. It does not generate the any error as a index out of bound error.
So whenever we perform the practical in which we use the command line argument, then we have to compulsory specify the size of array as the same as the argument dot length. So this is the example of a array to how to declare and initialize array at a runtime. That means we enter the elements of array at a runtime using a command line argument. Suppose you want to specify the value of array directly. That means without using the command line argument, you want to specify the array elements here directly with the declaration time. So for that, we have to just write here the array elements like in a curly bracket, we have to put like a 12, 13, 14 and 15. Okay. And the size of array will become as a dot length, means the length of elements. That means the value of element which are we specify here, it will be automatically converted as the size of length. Now again we run this program like this, and then we display the output. See here, 12 13 14 and 15. So this is the example of initializing array during a declaration time. So this is the example of array for declaring an array at and initializing array at a array declaration time. Hope now you are clear array in Java. That means how to declare, initialize an array in a Java, and what are the main features which are different from C and C++ of array in a Java. Thanks a lot for watching my video. Thank you again.